Time now to get up and close in our new segment, In the Saddle. This time, it's the scion of the Narredu family, Yash.
Yash Narredu is the new kid on the block in the professional world of racing, with a fresh outlook matched with a mature attitude. He spoke at length on his blossoming career and his various interests.
This is a very important stage of my life, and one has to be focused, and I am. And like it said in the showbiz, the three most important things are entertainment, entertainment, and entertainment. For me, it's only horses, horses, and horses. When I started off in Bombay, I rode just for 3 days. I had no winners. And after that, I moved to Bangalore to gain some more experience and confidence. My dad told me to start. He told me, move around, ride more horses. That's how you're going to gain more experience. My first winner was for Mr. Suleiman Atolai in the colours of Dr. Vijay Malia, which was a great start for me. And then I had around 23 winners over there. By the end of it, I was fighting for championship with my cousin Suraj. Since my childhood, I've been with the horses, with dad, with uncle, and with Suraj. We've only been around horses, and once you are with a horse, you fall in love with them. It's that easy to like them. It's a funny thing. I think that whenever we talk, even in a normal conversation, there's always horse language. And if there's someone else, a guest or someone who doesn't know, he's not going to understand. That's how it goes at home. Suppose we had athletics in school, like sports day or something, and suppose my brother was running or I was, and we would be like, if it was an 800 meter race, we would discuss it like we were riding a horse. Like, okay, we'll sit here, we'll sit there, and we'll want to spurt in the last 100 meters. It was that funny, and now when we think about it, it's like, why would we talk like that? The Invitation Cup is a very special race in my life, and I was quite lucky to get that ride, because I had never ridden Kwasar. In the morning track work and race, I never rode him before that. It happened to be that one day there was no one to ride him in the morning, and I supposedly cantered him. Dad asked me, would you canter him? I said yes, and I was quite excited to canter him. And that evening, Mr. Jaydev Modi asked Dad that who would be riding him, because there was no jockey available. Dad was trying to search for every jockey possible, but there was no one. And he asked Dad that who's riding him in the morning, and Dad said Yash cantered him today. And Mr. Jaydev Modi said that, so why don't we put Yash up? My dad was completely shocked. He's like, sir, he's a young boy, he's an apprentice still. We cannot take the risk of putting him up in the Invitation Cup. But he said that he had the confidence in me. Mr. Jaydev Modi supported me that time, and he gave my dad the confidence that no, we can put him up and he will ride well and he can win. My dad didn't even give me the instructions. He told me, enjoy the race, that's all. Mr. Jaydev Modi came up to me. He corrected my chin strap of my helmet and he said that, just win. Kwasar was a nice long striding horse, so we wouldn't like to break him and hold him back and fight with him. So, you know, I let him stride and he was in a good position like we wanted him to be. And then I just kept stepping on from there on and he galloped in the straight for me. He galloped on till the post and won for me. It was a big day and there was a lot of crowd, but at the winning post, it was like silence for me. I was not able to understand what happened, because I won the Invitation Cup, a group one, and for me winning at that stage, it was just the first year of mine, and I could not believe it that I won this race. I was understanding slowly that what race I have won and how much it means to me and how much it's going to take me ahead in my career. The crowd's behavior, they've always been like that, I think. If you win a race for them, they'll be cheering for you. The next race you lose, they will use abusive language and they will be angry. But it's okay, it's a part of racing and you have to take it. But that day, it was a little more than expected and they could just not digest the fact that a good horse has won. BSAF and Kwasar were meeting for the first time after the invitation. Whole of Bangalore was packed and the pressure at that moment, I cannot express it in words. But in the paddock, Mr. Jaydev Modi, my dad, the partners, they gave me so much confidence, the confidence I got at home. And we were like, we know a good horse is going to win. The better horse will win, you do your best. I was leading for champion jockey and I thought I'm going to become champion for the first time in my career of 2 years, and I was really looking forward to it. But unfortunately, I had a very bad fall. It didn't look that bad if you look at the video, but I had a fall and I broke my wrist. I broke my wrist and it got dislocated. So it could not be fixed without a surgery. So I had to go under a surgery, and there was a plate and 6 screws put in my wrist to fix it right. And that took over 3 months. The doctor told me that it's not going to break now, don't worry. What was supposed to be fixed, it's fixed. Now all you need to do is physiotherapy. And my physiotherapist would literally pull my wrist apart and bend it to make it right. And I thought he's going to break it, but it got me faster back on a horse. I came back after 3 months, and I was riding June, trained by Mr. Nirad Karanjewala. She won a first start with me in her career, and she went to the front. And I said that I'll do the same with her this time. And I knew from where to pick her up. She's a more of a one-paced filly. And I did that with her, and she won. My family told me from day one, with horses, I'm going to learn every day. And I wanted to improve. And Pat Smillan came down to ride for Dad in the Indian Derby. And I was hesitant in the start to go and talk to him, because I knew he's a top jockey, and I never spoke to someone at that level. But I went up to him with all the confidence, because I wanted to learn more and gain more experience. And I went up to him and asked him that, so that I need to gain a little bit of experience. Will it be possible for me to go anywhere abroad? Would you suggest something for me to go and learn? He said, yes, Yash, you can come down to Ireland and work with me. I was working for the top trainer, Mr. Dermot Weld, over there. And Pat Smillan was first jockey for him. And I was riding the best horses in Ireland. And I gained a lot of experience, because the way of his training was quite different. And also I was working with another trainer, Mr. John Fiend, who was giving me the rides in Ireland. And he supported me a lot. He was speaking to other trainers and letting them know about me, because no one knew me in Ireland. And he helped me a lot. He got me a few rides from the other trainers too. And because of Mr. Dermot Wells' name, I was known in Ireland after that. The jockeys in Ireland, they didn't expect much, they didn't know who I was, but then when they saw me ride, I got a lot of positive energy from them, which built my confidence even more. When I was leaving, I was with Colm O'Donoghue one day driving to a racetrack, and he told me that, Yash, you'll feel fresh when you go back home. That's what he does when he comes to India, and when he goes back to Ireland. Even if he's tired over here, he feels the energy in him, he told me. And I felt the same way, and he said that confidence is the key to winning races. I have had a few close friends, and marriage, I'm too soon to even think about it, and I want to be quite successful before I even have that thought in my mind. So yeah, I'm going to leave it there for now. Someone who can support me like my family does, and support my family too. I like playing cricket. The T20s are better. I think it's more fun to watch. Virat Kohli is my favorite for now. He inspires me because he wants to do better always, and that's what I want to do. I like to watch more of Hindi comedy movies. Recently, other than the comedy movies, I watched Dangal, and that movie has a lot to teach. If in that movie they've shown like how a father has inspired and made his two daughters to do what he could not. I think Ranbir Kapoor and Deepika Padukone, because Ranbir Kapoor, I love his personality. He's a man I would want to be. The way he is, the gentleman he is, that's how someone should be. I was not superstitious before when I started off, but when I started riding Kwasa, the colors, my racing goggles, and the breeches, these were a few things that I used only on him. I thought that they're lucky for me. I still don't believe that much in it, but it gets into your head that, you know, I want to do the same things that I did that day, and I hope it works that way. It makes me feel more comfortable. I love shopping. So if I get free time, I'll be gone in a mall or somewhere, just looking at, even if I'm not buying anything, I just love going around and looking at stuff that I really like. And yeah, I'm shopping, and then I'll meet a few friends if I'm free, if I'm not riding anywhere. Dad's always taught me to sleep early and get up early. I'm too young to advise the youngsters now, but by my experience, I can tell them that the three most important things are passion, dedication, and do what you love doing.